So by far my favorite thing about being able to do 3D design and 3D printing at home is being able to make cool custom stuff. I've been making these custom nameplates for a couple years now, and usually what I use them for is I make them for gifts, going away gifts, retirement gifts, things like that. And every time I give one of these to someone, everybody else is like, holy cow, where did you get that? Will you make me one? And I'm like, look, they are a little time consuming to put together, but what I certainly can do is share the files with all of you guys so you can put these together. So if you have just a tiny bit of technical acumen and a little bit of patience, I'm gonna show you how you can go from scratch with the base files for this and print these out and customize them for yourself. So let's get started. So I'm using Fusion 360, by far my favorite program that I've messed with over the years. And all I'm doing is I'm going to create a sketch. I'm going to create that sketch on the same plane as the back of my model and put my text in there. I'm going to use a bold font because bold fonts look a lot better when you 3D print them. Now I'm just going to center my name in the middle of the nameplate, and then I am going to pull it out of the model. By default, Fusion 360 cuts. I don't want it to cut. I need it to combine or create a new body. I use create new body because I want to be able to use this template for other nameplates, and it keeps them separate. So all I have to do is pull all these new bodies, which are all the different letters, into a new component, and that combines everything and lets me print them all out at once. So from there, all I'm doing is I'm exporting. And I'm going to export as an STL file, and this enables it to be able to get pulled into my 3D printing software really easily. So from there, the old handy and trusty MakerBot software. This is the older version because I have a replicator too, which is an older printer. And all you have to do is pull it to the center of the bed, and pretty much you're ready to go. I do want to mention right here that this model is really wide, and obviously I designed it to go as wide as my printer bed will allow. But a lot of printer beds on 3D printers aren't this wide, so you're going to have trouble. Well, the easy answer is just go back in your 3D software, and then once you have your combined model together, then just split it in half and print it in two pieces. It will not affect the outcome of this project. Now I'm just printing out all my models, and they should be ready to go. So I'm going to start off with some truck bed liner. I love this stuff. It gives an amazing texture for projects like this. From there, I'm going to use acrylic paint. And I use acrylic paint all the time because I love it because it's so easy to clean up because it's water-based. If you're worried about durability, you can either use like enamel paint, like the stuff you use on models and things, or you can simply do it in acrylic and then come back over it with some clear coat enamel. Clear, and that'll help with durability. So next up, we're going to talk about screws. I like to use hex screws in the front and wood screws in the back. I think the hex screws look really cool in the front of this project. I'm going to drill pilot holes into my plastic models to get the screws to go in nice and easy. And the trick here is just to make sure that the drill bits are the same size or a tiny bit smaller than the screws, and everything will fit nicely. So then I just fit the back brace on and ready for the next step. Then I just screw in the back brace, and then I line up my front piece, and I usually start with the center holes. And once I've drilled the pilot holes, then I just use my hex wrench to put in all the bolts on the front. So a few afterthoughts really quick, and the biggest one is, yes, I could model in the holes already into the model so you don't have to drill them. But at this point, I'm not ready to do that because I'm still refining the design a little bit. And trying to get it to line up is a real nightmare. So right now I haven't modeled in the holes, but what I plan on doing is doing that in the future. So for right now, just drill those pilot holes and it's super easy. So not a huge deal. Well, I really appreciate all your support. Let me know how your projects go. And if you got any questions, you know where to check us out. CommandedDesigns.com. I'm Tony D.